I'm now in the port of Glan in Sarangani, one of the destinations of the newly launched shipping service between Davao City and Bitung in Indonesia. But authorities have closed the port and declared it unsafe for operations due to the 7.2 magnitude quake on Saturday. As you can see, the runway sank by 15 centimeters due to the quake, and they declared it as unfit for heavy trucks, especially that are going in here. The repair for the restoration of the port, for the restoration of the integrity of the port, might last for more than a month, and depending on the weather conditions. Now, according to authorities, this might also affect commerce in the town, since many exporters of agricultural products use the port for their business. Also, many structures in the town were damaged. In the municipal hall, cracks were spotted on the walls. The public market, a police station, and a hospital also sustained cracks due to the quake. But for the rest of the town, life went back to normal as if nothing has happened. We have seen families camping out in the town's idyllic beaches. Many houses and trees are still standing. Van services from General Santos City were seen at the town's terminal. Residents of this seaside town say they're aware that anytime they might be hit by a tsunami in case of a strong quake. That's why they've been used to handling disasters immediately by evacuating to safer areas. Back to you.
Rex, how many were injured due to the quake after all the assessment?
According to the Regional Disaster Office, already five have been injured by the quake. Two of them are in a Lake Cebu town, also in South Cotabato, and the three others are in the town of Glan here in Sarangani, and they're now being treated in nearby hospitals. Back to you.